Good morning, children. Welcome to the online classes. We were going to do our history lesson, the Mesopotamian civilization. Previous lesson we have done, the topic was the origin and location, where Mesopotamia is located. It is in Iraq, now modern day Kuwait, and its literal meaning is Mesopotamia means land between the two rivers, and the two rivers name is Tigris and the Euphrates. Let's see, today's topic is features of Mesopotamian civilization. Town planning. The city of Ur and other prominent city of Mesopotamia were built with a protective wall around them. The wall were cut at right angles and towers were built there. They were also surrounded by small villages. The main temple in the sacred area of the town was built on a multi-layered platform or ziggurats dedicated to the patron god of the city. The central part was inhabited by the rich and the powerful people of the society. The rest of the city was made up of narrow lanes, and the houses were built along them. The house did not face the street but had open courtyard, and all the rooms opened into it. They had a door-like opening in the external wall which connected the house to the street. So children, the city of Ur, it is the Mesopotamia having a city named by Ur, and it was protected by walls. The city was protected by walls all around it, and city was made with narrow lanes. They had multi-layered platforms or called ziggurat. In the center of the town was the temple area where their gods dwelt, and the priest and the kings were the high people of that time period. Only the rich and the powerful people lived in this area. There were towers also and small villages around surrounding them. Community structure. Ancient Mesopotamia was divided into different social classes. At the top, the class were the king and priest. Children, the Mesopotamian were having different classes. The first upper class was the king and the priest. They were the higher rank people. The middle class consisted of farmers, traders and artisans. Mostly farmers and the middle class people were farmers and traders. Traders are who do business people who take their things from one place to another. An artisan who makes pottery and other things. The king was the head of the army and made all the rules. So children, at that time the people had king as the leader who lead the people for army. Priests also served as doctors. At that time the most learned person was the priest, who was called doctor at that time, and he was very influential, meaning powerful. The middle class was the core of the social structure and contributed to the growth of the economy. Only the middle class people were the people who had to take care of the growth of the economy. The common man was not educated and primarily engaged in agriculture activities. People at that time, they were not well educated, and they had been seeing the well-to-do of the agriculture part. The slaves served all the other classes. The slaves were serving the king, the priest, the middle class. So the slaves were treated at that time like no other slave as today. Family. Males were considered more important in the society, and father was the head of the family. His wife and children had to follow the rules laid down by him. So the head of the family was father, and he had laid down the rules for the family, and everybody had to follow. The child, the wife had to follow the rules what the father has laid down. The boys were taught skills to help them earn a living, and girls were trained to take care of the house and children. As small boys were growing, they were trained to look after the household requirements, and the girls were trained to look after the smaller kids in the family. Occupation. Agriculture was the main occupation because abundant supply of water throughout the year. They had irrigation, very good irrigation system. So they were agriculturally very efficient and they had plenty of agriculture benefits. They invented ox-drawn plow and used transport with wheels for goods. They had done trade on wheels. They were the first who are believed to have cultivated wheat, barley and pulses and fruit as well. They were the ones from our ancestors we get wheat, barley and pulses. That means at that time period they were the first invention of wheat, barley and pulses and fruits. Mesopotamian built a highly developed irrigation system because of irregular flooding in the river Euphrates and Tigris. They built dikes to control floods. So they were having flood problems at that time. So irrigation was having flooding. So they had the system of dikes to control flood, to stop the water to flooding their fields. Jewelry making, carpentry, shoemaking and weaving were the other occupation of the people of this civilization. As fast as the agriculture was developing, many other areas were also coming up. They knew the art of making jewelry, shoemaking, carpentry and other weaving and other things. Animals such as ox, cow, ox, sheep, donkeys were also domesticated. Trade. Mesopotamia had a flourishing trade and they trade in wool, cloth, grains, oil and jewelry. Trade, children, you know, one person takes his things to another country and sell it goods is called trade. They use barter system and exchange these items along with silver, gold, tin, copper and barley to buy things such as stone, timber and metal. Or trade was carried out with Egypt, Mediterranean countries and even Indus Valley. The record of trade was inscribed on clay tablets. So people did barter system. Mesopotamian people had this culture of taking their things and giving to other people, and other people giving their things to them is called barter system. No money was introduced, only they were taking their things and taking over other people's things in exchange. This, children, is called barter system, and it was introduced by Mesopotamian people. So children, till here, till trade, we end this lesson session. We will meet in the next session. Thank you, children.